Tai pirmas kėlinys, neslėpsiu, tikrai buvo mano atžvilgiu geras, atidavėm visą save, taip pat ir antrasis kėlinys, nepasakyčiau, kad buvo blogas, mes taip pat kovojom, taip pat stengiamės, tai įvarčiai tiesiog pasidarė iš nieko, bet mes tiesiog darėm, ką galėjom ir atidavėm visą save, visą širdim.
Na, žaisti prieš Europos čempionės 10 vis tiek buvo turbūt daug sunkiau.
Žinoma, daug sunkiau, bet mes turime iš žiūrovų daug palaikymo, tai buvo kaip dar papildomas žaidėjas 11.
Ir kaip vertini visą čempionatą, kokia tai patirtis jūsų komandai?
Kaip komandai mes iš šito čempionato daug pasiimsim, tai mums sutvirtins artimiau, draugė daug laiko praleidom, tai mums kiekviena žaidėja tapo dar artimesnė ir brangesnė vienas kitai, tai čia didžiausias pasiekimas turbūt tai, kad tapome dar didesnį šeimą, artimesnis vienas kitai.
Gintarė, rungtynės tokiom stipriom varžovėm pridės daug patirties jūsų komandai?
Manau tikrai taip, daugiau pasitikėjimo, drąsesnės išeisim į aikštę, noras didesnis bus žaisti, pasitikėjimas komandos draugėmis, žinoma.
The first half was incredible, honestly. If we talk about it, the girls fought so hard. Our preparation helped them, our preparation as a staff and as players just helped them start off strong. We started off strong, we went all in. We were unlucky with the call from the referee that ended up giving us a red card. But I mean, you must have seen yourself just how amazingly the whole team was able to stick together, you know? And then we made some adjustments. You know, as a staff, we made some adjustments, fixing, okay, who has to go where, adjusted our tactics a little bit about how to still get a chance in attack. Overall, I can only be happy. When it comes to the second half, again, we're playing a man down, a woman down, for the whole second half. So, and we still fought like hell. So I can only be happy about how hard our girls worked. They really showed that they were proud for the country.
And the whole tournament, how do you rate it as an experience for the team? How good was it?
Amazing. Honestly, we worked, right? I've been with them for 1.5 years working towards this. And each game got better, and each game, I mean, we just see it as an amazing step forward. The fear, not the fear now, but okay, it's great that we have the academy that we know is continuing. We got the news, okay, it's continuing. We're hoping that the staff stays the same and it doesn't go back to old school coaches, that we keep going with this modern way of coaching so that this isn't just, oh, we did this and boom, we're done. That is, we did this and look at how much more we can keep going. Let's see how we can be in 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years from now. That's all I have to say.
And the three opponents you played, they even Finland won against Netherlands. How do you rate this group and the experience you gained from playing them?
It was an amazing experience. Good quality teams is really what we can say. We didn't have an easy group, right? And there was just so much competition going on in our group. I think every team had these incredible qualities that we were able to learn from. Three teams that played pretty differently, and these are all teams that we can now look back on and hopefully future be like, oh, I remember when we played against Finland, okay, it was more physical, okay, that's what we need to be doing this game. Or we're playing against Germany, they're a bit more disciplined and doing it a certain way, okay, all right, we need to adjust to that. So it's going to just add to their the whole way that they think about football and everything that they know. Again, when it came to the way that we played, when we're playing against big teams, sometimes you need a little bit of luck on your side to be able to get that chance, right? And that luck was not quite on our side. And maybe next time it'll be a little bit more on our side.
How did the girls take when, well, the results didn't come for this tournament? How did they react to this, these situations?
It's all about how you talk about it, because with us, we talk a lot about how the result itself, the numbers on the board, that doesn't mean if you're a good team or a good player or not. What matters is the actual performance that you do on the pitch, sticking to the principles, sticking to the whole mental game we have, the whole game plan. And if you do that, and if you perform well on the pitch, you know, it's about the journey instead of the destination, right? And we're teaching them about every step of the way, how every step is important on the pitch, every minute's important on the pitch. So again, the girls, we know what was on the scoreboard. We don't care. We know how hard we worked on the pitch. We're not at that level yet in Lithuania. We could only be focusing on results because we don't have results in any of the other leagues or any of the other national teams right now, right? We have nothing else we can look up to. So it has to start from here. It has to start from, okay, developing, and then boom, the results are going to come in a few years' time for all the teams. Bye-bye.
We are satisfied. We won the game today, and we reached the semifinal. We won our group. So at the end everything is, was okay today. It was the game was a little bit at the beginning. I don't want to say boring, but it was hard because Lithuania played so defensively, and we had a lot of chances, but we didn't score. We only scored one goal in the first half, and we normally we have to score four or five, and yeah, so we have to work hard for the second and the third goal, and then Lithuania get down. They broke a little bit down after the I think the third goal, and after the red card for sure. So then it was easier for us to score more goals. So we are satisfied with the results. We are satisfied with the with our performance, because we know that we have to play. I don't know the right word. Calm, very calm, and to get through the defense of Lithuania, and I think we did it in a good way.
And did you have the target, you know, to score, to get a better goal difference than the Netherlands? Did you set that for the team?
No, this was not our main goal. For sure, when you can score, this is all the time good for the girls, and even if. At the end of the game, where we have where we are in the lead with 8-0 or 7-0 or something like this, they still want to score another goal. But our goal was not to have the better goal difference to the Netherlands, because we don't know how they play. So our goal was to perform well and to have kind of fun on the pitch.
And Finland won against the Netherlands. How surprised it for you, and how do you rate this group in general?
After the draw, I said it was a very tough group. So Netherlands, Finland, and us, three really really good teams. I thought it would be all those teams could reach the semifinal. After the game of we played against Finland, I said I think that Finland will reach the semifinal. For the Netherlands, it was very hard to play against us. It was a hard game. They lost one player, so they have to play for more than half an hour with only 10 players. We draw in the last minute. So for not only for the body, also for the mind, it was a hard game. So I'm not that surprised that Finland reached the semi-final, because Finland played well. Good structure, good system, good players. The same as Netherlands, and I think it was a very close game. But in the end, Finland go second through the finish line.
And Lithuania, you can now compare. You played them in August, and then today, how different was it to play against them?
They improved their game. They improved their structure. All the girls are better than they were in August. There's no huge tradition of women's football in Lithuania, so it was hard for them in our group, because there are three really good teams they have to face and have to play against. But I think they did it very well. They did the best they can, and when I look back into August, they get better, and this is the main thing, to make one step after the other to reach the next goal and to develop the players, the girls. And I think this happened here in the last couple of months. And I hope that this way go through, so that there's also in the future there will be effort and manpower and also money in programs to develop girls in football.